My name is Holly, and I am at war with the fighting. What an interesting artifact. And I know what you're thinking. Hollis Holly, you've spoken about this before, and you're absolutely right. But I am more serious now. I'm sick of sea fighting, and so it's getting its own video. Just to clarify, that clip is not what sea fighting is. It kind of is, technically. I don't know.
AI is only funny when I use it, guys.
What is Z-fighting? Z-fighting is that ugly, jittering thing that you just see in games in Roblox all the time for some reason. It's that horrible flashing that happens when two parts are close together or overlapping, and it's disgusting. Essentially, Z-fighting is just the GPU trying to figure out which surface to draw. It's the phenomenon that happens in 3D spaces where two planes are either really close together or overlapping, and it causes this flashing. The reason it's called Z-fighting is because it happens along the Z-axis, the forward and backward. When two parts share the same space, one is not more forward than the other. They're fighting with each other for the view, and that's why it flashes. It actually surprises me how few developers on Roblox know this. But yeah, you see this everywhere in games on Roblox, but especially low-quality, rushed games. These things are unfortunately all over Roblox, and they suck, because all that motivates these developers is money.
In this video, I'm gonna show you the best ways to make Robux.
That's why they pump out games so fast. They spend no time making actual quality builds, and they refuse to go out of their way to fix Z-fighting when they see it. If you want an example of a good build, well, you should look no further than Fantasy Park. Fantasy Park are kindly sponsoring today's video, and oh my goodness, am I glad that they are. Because look at this, look at it. Now, you already know that I will not take on sponsorships if it isn't something that I absolutely love. And let me tell you, when I was walking around this game, I was in absolute awe. It is so well made. This is such a fun place to take a group of friends, or even like a one-to-one date with a bestie. You can get a mobility scooter. Where do I go? What do I do? There's so much to see. Oh my goodness, you can get pastries. So I'm currently waiting for this ride. There's a little bro in here making sure that everything is running smoothly. Whoa! Honestly, this ride could cure depression. Machina Tempus. I think this is their newest update. Okay, they've got NPCs. This is such good environmental design and lighting. But yeah, this place is absolutely huge. There's so much content. Like, you could get lost in here for hours. And you know what my favorite part is? No Z-fighting. This game was only made by 3 people. And in spite of that, they've managed to make a game with so much care and quality and attention to detail. Their Discord community also is such a lovely place. I personally love that they host little events on their YouTube channel with their players. These guys seriously care about their audience so much, and it is exactly the kind of thing I want to show you guys. I've linked the game and their Discord server in the description. We really need to give support to these little dev teams that are actually passionate about their games, because you already know Roblox is not doing that. I genuinely think you'll love it, so please check it out. Hopefully I'll see you there and we can play it together. Thank you so much, Fantasy Park, for sponsoring today's video, and thank you, the viewer, for not skipping this ad. If you want to get your own Roblox game promoted on my channel, the Google Doc with all of the information is linked in the description. Anyways, Z-fighting! From the player's point of view, what is the problem? Well, first of all, Z-fighting is visual noise. Take a look at this super calm environment, and then there's just this flashing thing that's just there. It completely takes you out of it. It's visual noise, and it's distracting you from what would have been a really aesthetic and soothing game. It makes environments feel unstable and broken. You don't see this kind of thing in AAA games, or even indie games on like Steam, because those developers actually care about quality assurance. And so when you see it in Roblox, it just makes your game look incomplete. It looks like you've missed a step. And most importantly, in my opinion, it distracts you from the gameplay and the immersion. Trying to play some kind of immersive horror game, and then there's just this flashing thing, and it just completely takes you out of the environment. It's awful. The majority of players do not know what Z-fighting is, but they can feel it. When I see a game with lots of Z-fighting, I immediately just think they didn't put much effort into the build quality. But Why? Even the most detailed build on Roblox can just completely lose its value from Z fighting. And the main reason for that is because it's almost always avoidable. It's so easy to see and it's so easy to fix. It literally takes a couple seconds, and I'll show you how in a bit. But the fact that it's so avoidable just screams to me that you didn't care about it in the first place. It also, like I mentioned earlier, shows a lack of playtesting. If you had a quality assurance, a QA playtester, they would look at that and they would inform you of it and you'd be tasked to fix it. This is what happens in the games industry. So when you see Z fighting in Roblox games, all I can think is, okay, they haven't actually playtested this. I mean, it's quite obviously there, so they must have just not been there in the first place. It also suggests a rushed building. Z fighting usually takes a minute to fix, but those minutes can really add up. And for a lot of people that are working really fast when building and trying their best to get something done at a deadline, Z fighting is not on the top of their list of things that they want to correct. Think of things like misaligned UI when you're playing a Roblox game, when you're trying to click a button but there's a piece of UI over the top, and think of how annoying that is. Think of when you notice something is unanchored in a game. Z fighting is just like that. It's those things that are easy to fix and they're completely avoidable, but they're there anyway, because the developer just doesn't seem to be interested in fixing it. Do you really want that to be how your player base see you? So Z fighting can come up anywhere. That's why it's so common after all. But if you have Z fighting in your game, it's probably because of one of these things. Number one, you're stacking parts with identical Y values. This is just a fancy way of saying multiple of the same part are in one place. Decals placed directly on faces can also cause this problem. Parts that are intersecting, for example, when you're making windows, you usually build them horizontally and then rotate and build them vertically. And then that part where they're intersecting, that's where Z fighting usually occurs as well. The final biggest place that I've noticed Z fighting is when you're copy-pasting multiple objects and not really checking where they overlap. I see this predominantly in fences, where the fence posts are close together. So yeah, really try and pay attention to these specific areas when you're doing this in building. Now, if Roblox development was a religion, this should be written in blood on the first page of the Bible of development. Do not have Z fighting on floors, walls, door frames, stairs, or signs. These are all places that the player regularly looks at. This is where your best foot needs to be put forward, and so if there's any Z fighting on it, that's a really bad sign. This stuff is especially bad in horror games, where the immersion in the environment is what the player relies on to be afraid. First person games are also especially important for this, because it's right in your face when they see it, and games with a lot of flat surfaces as well, because there's less distraction. It's far more likely that they're going to see it and pay attention to it. Whenever I point out Z fighting to developers, they usually tell me they never even noticed it. What? How? It's jittering in your face? Different camera angles and movements especially exaggerate it. Notice how when I move my camera, it flashes even more. And if you've got lighting on it, congratulations, it's now flickering. Luckily for you, my fellow developers, Z fighting is so easy to fix. Small positional offsets. Uncheck the stud mark so that you're moving on zero studs, and just ever so slightly pull it back or size it back. It may still appear to Z fight if you're very, very far away from it, in which case you may need to pull it back a tiny bit further. Proper building spacing. I like to call this building on the stud, or increments of the stud. Whenever you're sizing anything, moving anything, do it on some kind of increment of the stud, whether that be one stud, 0.5, 0.25. 0.1, 0.05, 0.025. Just please make sure it's dividable into a whole number. You really shouldn't be using zero studs. I only ever use zero studs for nature. And the reason you use increments of the stud is because when you resize it and when you move it, it will always be perfectly aligned. There will never be any overlapping. This is the main problem that my boyfriend had when he was trying to build that sink.
There's an overhang and I don't want there to be a fucking overhang, so I have to change my stupid stud settings again.
Using unions, carefully. If you've got two parts that are overlapping, click, click, union, done. But just be careful with how you go about it. Do some research into when you should union and when you shouldn't union. But yeah, all of these things fix Z fighting in seconds. Like, guys, it actually takes seconds. Stop being lazy. Please do not try and fix it by just making one part transparent. It feels stupid that I have to say this, but yeah. Also, please don't just slap decals everywhere. Hiding Z fighting by using decals is just a bit silly because it adds extra triangles. But the number one thing, ignoring Z fighting because the player won't notice. They will. I'm making a YouTube video about it. We clearly notice it. This is going to be controversial, but I'm gonna say it anyway because I can handle you. Zoo fighting is a symptom of bigger problems. Zoo fighting is a sign that you have poor asset workflow. It shows that you have very low building standards, and it shows that you also don't have a visual QA pass. You clearly aren't looking over your game, making sure that it looks correct before you upload it. This is like the bare minimum of what you should do with a game. Look over the build, make sure there are no problems. If you see problems, fix it and then upload. What's wrong with you? Zoo fighting just to me says that you have this speed over quality mindset. Because zoo fighting takes time out of your day to fix, it's something that a lot of people just don't want to do. And as game development Jesus, the creator of Mario, Shigeru Miyamoto, once said, a delayed game is eventually good. A rushed game is bad forever. I know it sucks to have a random British girl demean you about your Roblox development, and I'm sorry. If you're going to take anything away from this video, I encourage you to do this. Take a closer look at your builds. Properly analyze them. I'm doing this all the time. I'll be building on Roblox and then all of a sudden I'll be just walking around my build, making sure that everything is perfect. The best way to figure out what the problem is to look for it. I challenge you to completely eliminate Zoo fighting from your build. Go around your build right now. Take a look for it and get rid of it. And tell me in my server when you've done it. Before adding any new features to your game, spend a day getting rid of it. Sit down, get your favorite drink, put on a movie or some music in the background, and get to work getting rid of all the Zoo fighting. It's actually quite therapeutic. And remember this, the thing that separates good builds from forgettable builds is polish. Because trust me, you don't notice when everything looks good, but you sure do notice when it doesn't. I have been Hollis Holly. I've been building on Roblox for 7 years. If you ever want to show off anything that you've made, and if you're looking for further building advice, my Discord server is a great place to go if you're over the age of 13. We're very, very nice. I promise we won't bite. A huge thank you to my YouTube members. These guys got to see this video before everybody else, and they help support my teeny tiny little channel. You mean the world to me. We're coming up to the end of the new year, so continue to be kind to others, and thank you so much for your support this year. You mean more to me than you will ever know. Don't forget to check out Fantasy Park, and yeah, I will see you next week. Goodbye.